In this video, we'll go through the search function of Gmail. So Gmail is part of the Google suite, and as you might know, Google is a very powerful search engine. So Gmail, therefore, is also going to be pretty powerful with a search. So the search box is at the top here. And there are different ways to search. The first way you can search is by people's emails. And if you just start typing in an email, let's type in Alex, it'll already pull up Alex's email. So I'm going to press the tab key or the right arrow key and press enter. And that'll pull up all the emails that are from or to Alex and that have Alex's email address in them. Let's have another go. Let's type in Peter's email address this time. And you can see all the emails in a split second pop up that have Peter's name in them. You can also search just by people's names. If I just type in Alex, then all emails which have the word Alex in it will pop up. So if you've come from Outlook or you love folders and love organizing, you might have been used to having a folder for every client or having a folder for different people. So this is one of the key differences as well with Gmail, is you don't need to now create folders with people's names on them, because in a split second, just like we saw with Alex, you can pull up all the emails with that person's name. Another way you can search, just as you do in Google, is just by typing keywords in. So, for example, I want to find an email which has Peter, Hazel, and Regina in it, and I think it was about annual leave. So if I just put in Peter's name, that will work, and we'll find everything with the word Peter. But there's 42 emails, and I don't want to go through all those. Let me also type in Regina and Hazel and annual leave. And that's narrowed it down to 14 emails. So that's another way to search. Let's go back to the inbox. One of my favorite ways to search as well is using the has semicolon. So if I type in has, I can type in has an attachment. It'll pull up everything that has an attachment. And the other thing I like to do is search by colored stars. So let's see, has a blue star. This is my search history here. And immediately, everything that has have a blue star in it has just been popped up there. If you do want to go into more advanced search functions, at the right hand here, right hand side of the search bar, there's a little arrow. If you click this arrow here, it'll then bring a drop down, and you can search specific emails that were from someone to someone with a subject line, which include specific words, or which don't include specific words. You can also search by different sizes and by different dates. So this date one might be very helpful for some. And here is the attachment button as well, if you did want to search for attachments. Let's just get out of there. And one final way to search that I find useful is things like spreadsheets or documents. So if I know that I'm looking for an email that had a spreadsheet in it, I can also type in has and type in spreadsheet, for example, and that'll pull up the emails that have spreadsheets. So I have a look there. This one has two spreadsheets here, and the second one here also has a spreadsheet in it there as well. So that is a couple of ways that you can use search in Gmail. I hope that's been helpful.
If you like this content, please hit subscribe and hit the bell notification so you can be notified when we go live or drop new content on the channel. Now, if you'd like to connect with us, hit us up on social media or join our free community group. All the links to that are right below this video. If you'd like to learn more about Google Workspace and the technology ecosystem, you can join our free Genius Academy by transferring your billing across to itGenius, or you can join a Workspace Basics Bootcamp. Now, if you're a business owner and you're interested in an audit on your technology stack or your Workspace account, or you're looking to do a project in the tech world, well, you can take advantage of our free consultation. And if you need help right now, then consider joining Concierge or taking up a quick fix with our team for professional support for your tech stack.